Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Dr. David Niesel. I'm the Dean of the Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences. Welcome to the Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences 2020 Commencement, where we celebrate the hard work and accomplishments of the students receiving their advanced degrees today. Although we are holding our proceedings virtually due to COVID-19, please know that the Dean's, UTMB administration, and GSBS staff have endeavored to capture many of the elements of our traditional ceremony in this video, albeit in a virtual fashion. Above all, this day is about our graduates, and we honor each and every one of you for reaching this remarkable milestone. You will go on to pursue a variety of careers and will become leaders of the future, and that is worth celebrating. Please enjoy the proceedings today, and may family, friends, and colleagues celebrate the momentous accomplishments of this outstanding class of 2020. Congratulations to you all.
Good afternoon. I'm Dr. David Niesel, Dean of the Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences and the Associate Chief Research Officer here at the University of Texas Medical Branch at Galveston. I have the honor of officiating these commencement exercises, and I welcome you all. I would like to extend a warm welcome to the family and friends of those graduating today, to the graduate faculty, and especially to you, the students, whose hard work and achievements we celebrate today. This is an unusual and challenging year with the COVID-19 pandemic altering almost everything we do. We are getting used to new terms like social and physical distancing and quarantine because they are ruling our lives. We are wearing and sometimes making masks to keep us safe when we are in public. And we are hearing about the many who unfortunately have been directly affected by this new infectious disease. This crisis reminds us of why we conduct biomedical research. Biomedical research is the future of medicine and the hope for new effective screening technologies, therapeutics, and vaccines to combat COVID-19. Despite this major public health emergency, today remains one of the most important events of our academic year, commencement, where we recognize the achievements of the newest next generation of biomedical graduates. We will celebrate today, albeit a little differently. The Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences is one of the four schools at UTMB, which also includes the School of Health Professions, the School of Medicine, and the School of Nursing. We celebrated the 50th anniversary as a degree-granting graduate school last year. In these 50 years, we have awarded more than 1,300 doctoral degrees, more than 1,000 master's degrees, and 110 MD-PhD combined degrees. Since 1969, when 9 students were awarded a doctoral degree and 10 were awarded a master's degree, many students have gone on to successful careers. Rebecca Ball, a 1987 microbiology and immunology graduate, went on to receive a law degree and practices intellectual property law in Indianapolis. And Michael Droege, a 1982 anatomy graduate, had a long academic career, became a provost, and then a university president. They are indicative of our graduates who emerge into leadership positions at universities and colleges, biotech and pharma, and government positions, taking advantage of a whole host of opportunities available to those with advanced degrees in the biomedical sciences. Biomedical science is about advancing medicine. Our scientists work to understand the fundamentals of life, and in doing so, new explanations for disease, new diagnostics, therapeutics, and vaccines. No matter how fundamental the project is, the goal is always focused on the improvement of the health of Texans, all Americans, and of people around the world. As students can attest, earning a graduate degree requires a tremendous amount of hard work, scholarly accomplishment, and a lot of perseverance. All these students have worked on research projects with their faculty mentors and advisory committees that have contributed new knowledge that advances their fields. Now, to the families and friends listening, thank you for your patience. How many of you have understood the projects your graduates have worked on with their heart and soul these last few years? Maybe a little? Let me reassure you that your student has been hard at work here at UTMB and has produced important new discoveries in achieving their degrees. It's been worth it. Your graduate is about to embark on an exciting and satisfying career. Students, many of you will go on to become leading researchers in your fields. Earning an advanced degree in biomedical science has opened a gateway that you will benefit from your entire career. What distinguishes you from others is the creative and innovative way you think about and solve problems. You will be unique and valuable in whatever career you choose because of these abilities. As professionals and scientists, I remind you of your important responsibilities. You have the responsibility to educate and communicate to the public what you do. This is challenging as we use a highly technical language and the concepts we explore are complex. You have the responsibility to stand up for good science and for correcting distortions or misrepresentations of science. This has become increasingly important in this era of alternative facts, wild conspiracy theories, and deliberate misrepresentations of science for political and other purposes. You are obliged to keep the public safe while advancing science. It is important to ensure that science moves from the bench to the bedside or into the commercial world in a safe and rigorous manner. Applications of your work for use by people will be the ultimate payoff for your work. Finally, remember to include diverse populations in your work. This broadens the impact of your discoveries. All should benefit from the investment made in the advancement of biomedical science. Enough advice from me. We recognize all the students here today and also all those who completed their degree requirements last August and December. All will join the more than 2,500 graduates as GSBS alumni. Achieving an advanced degree in biomedical science is a major accomplishment and one that will impact your career throughout your lifetime. We will follow your careers with special interest and will take great pride in hearing about your future successes. I join the entire faculty and staff of the Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences in saying congratulations and best wishes as you pursue the next chapters of your careers. At this time, I invite UTMB President ad interim and GSBS alumnus, Dr. Ben Raymer, to make some remarks. Dr. Raymer.
Good day, graduates. Congratulations on this tremendous academic milestone. Your graduation from the UTMB Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences is an accomplishment for us to applaud. You are entering the lives of service in a most interesting and challenging time. The fact that we are conducting this year's commencement virtually is just one sign of how a pandemic has changed the world in which we live. But no challenge is too great for your class. I have no doubt that you will approach your work with the same perseverance and excellence that has marked your academic career at UTMB. Like graduates before you, your class will go on to hold influential positions in universities, in government, and in industry around the world. Whatever career path you choose, you will have limitless opportunities ahead of you. Opportunities to discover and learn, opportunities to teach, opportunities to innovate, and most importantly, opportunities to improve the health and the well-being of others. Seize those opportunities and responsibilities with the same drive and determination that brought you to this point today. Know that your successes and the advances you will make for humanity are possible as a part of a powerful UTMB legacy. Know also that our wonderful faculty are behind you, just as they have been throughout your training and education. As a member of the Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences class of 1970, I know from firsthand experience the caliber of UTMB's world-class faculty. I know that each of you remember fondly and gratefully those who have shared their knowledge and their expertise with you during your journey to this point. These educators are the backbone of our university. By teaching the future health sciences workforce, they make a lasting difference in the lives of people around the globe. At UTMB, You as alumni will do the same. Because of you, I am most optimistic for our future, particularly at this very conflicted time. You have the best wishes and support of our entire UTMB faculty. I know you will continue to make UTMB proud in the years to come, in your career and in your life. As you start this next chapter in your life, please accept my sincere and heartfelt congratulations. I am honored to call each of you fellow UTMB Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences alumni. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Raymer. I now welcome Dr. Charles Mouton to make some comments. Dr. Mouton?
It is an honor and pleasure to address the 2020 graduating class of the University of Texas Medical Branch Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences. You have put a tremendous amount of work into reaching this milestone, and you should be very proud. When you entered into your training, you brought forth an aptitude for science and a passion for discovery. The education you received here at UTMB now opens the door for you to apply your knowledge in a way that will improve the lives of others and make the world a healthier place. As we navigate an unprecedented public health crisis with the COVID pandemic, the immense need for talented, dedicated biomedical scientists have never been more apparent. You play a critical role in our healthcare system, doing work that supports diagnosis, treatment, and prevention of diseases, and developing new treatments that improve longevity and the quality of life. With the achievement of this advanced degree, you become part of a renowned group of UTMB alumni who are working to improve health worldwide in a wide array of fields and positions. This is important because no matter which path you choose, you will have the potential to make a positive difference in the lives of others. Throughout your career, I hope that you will remember all you have gained from your time here at UTMB. You have learned from some of the most talented, committed, and supportive educators one could hope to know. You have worked through challenges and learned how to be effective collaborators. You have made valuable contributions to the world of science, advancing our knowledge and understanding of health. And you have come to appreciate the excitement you feel with every new discovery that leads to a groundbreaking innovation. I implore you to hold tight to this passion for discovery. It will motivate you through challenging times, and it will keep you inspired to work hard for that next breakthrough. I know that you will do great work. Congratulations, class of 2020. I wish you much success.
Thank you, Dr. Mouton. Now, to continue our program, each year at Commencement, we bestow a number of awards for distinguished accomplishments. The first is the Graduate Student Organization Distinguished Teaching Award. It is my pleasure to introduce Ms. Stefania Socheff, President of the Graduate Student Organization, to announce this year's recipient. Stefania?
Thank you, Dr. Niesel. Each year, the Graduate Student Organization selects a faculty member from the Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences who has made outstanding contributions to the academic growth and development of students. GSO members make their selection based on teaching skills, tutorial excellence, and overall quality of and enthusiasm for graduate teaching. This year, it is my pleasure to present this award to Dr. Eric Wagner, Associate Professor in the Department of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. Dr. Wagner received his bachelor's degree in molecular genetics from the University of Rochester. He then moved to North Carolina to pursue his doctorate in molecular cancer biology from Duke University. He completed his postdoctoral training at UNC prior to moving to Texas in 2008. Before joining UTMB in 2015, Dr. Wagner served as an assistant professor and director of the graduate program in the Department of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology at the University of Texas Health Science Center at Houston, or UTHSCH. His research focuses on the termination of mRNAs. His projects include investigating the activity of the integrator complex, 3' UTR shortening in pulmonary vascular disease, and the regulation of fibrosis in systemic sclerosis via alternative polyadenylation. For these projects, he's been granted funds from Harvard University, UTHSCH, and the Welch Foundation. Dr. Wagner teaches portions of the biochemistry and molecular biology courses for first-year students in the basic biomedical sciences curriculum, and team teaches the RNA biology course within the Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences. His students recognize him not only for his passion for teaching and organization, but also for his dedication to ensuring that his students are able to understand the complex subject matter by making class engaging and entertaining. A student nominator wrote, "Although there is a lot to cover in the metabolism section of biochemistry, Dr. Wagner finds ways to keep the class engaged and map out the pathways building on one another in a way that makes sense. His energy makes all of us want to attend class." Dr. Wagner's commitment to his students and their success is unmistakable, and in recognition of his consistent effort and support, the Graduate Student Organization is pleased to honor him with this award. Congratulations, Dr. Wagner.
Thank you, Ms. Socheff. Our next award, the GSBS Distinguished Faculty Service Award, is presented to a faculty member who has excelled in service to the graduate school over a substantial period of time. This year, we honor Dr. Tracy Tolliver Kinski with the 2020 Distinguished Faculty Service Award. Dr. Tolliver Kinski is a GSBS alumnus and professor in the Department of Anesthesiology and a member of the Biochemistry and Molecular Biology graduate program. She has contributed to an enormous number of GSBS and BBSC committees that impact every aspect of graduate student life, from admission through graduation. Her exemplary long service extends over a decade and includes significant contributions to multiple departments and graduate programs, as well as to her own students. Dr. Tolliver Kinski has made significant contributions to the development and innovation of graduate education. She is the director and one of the principal architects of the Basic Biomedical Science Curriculum, which is the first year foundational curriculum for our entering students. She continues to bring innovative ideas to the curriculum year after year to enhance the training of our students. Her nomination was by first-year BBSC students who felt strongly that her efforts have a great impact on their education and success. Congratulations, Dr. Tolliver Kinski. Our next award, the GSBS Distinguished Faculty Research Award, is presented annually to a faculty member whose research has made an impact on a broad field of science or whose work shows ingenuity and originality within an important scientific arena. This year, we honor Dr. Alfredo Torres with the 2020 GSBS Distinguished Faculty Research Award. Dr. Torres is the Herman Barnett Distinguished Professor in the Department of Microbiology and Immunology, the Associate Dean of Faculty Affairs and Professional Development in the School of Medicine, and the UTMB Chief Diversity Officer. He has conducted a strong, continuously funded, and internationally recognized research program in bacterial pathogenesis and vaccine development. He is a global authority in the study of diarrheal disease pathogens and those representing biodefense threats. He is the author of more than 150 scholarly works and has trained and launched 27 doctoral and postdoctoral trainees into successful careers. Dr. Torres is a highly recognized Hispanic leader in biomedical education and research and highly deserving of this research award. Congratulations, Dr. Torres. The final award today recognizes alumni of the GSBS who have made substantial contributions to their fields since leaving UTMB. The GSBS Distinguished Alumnus Award is presented to a graduate who has achieved special recognition in his or her professional career. This year, we honor Dr. Tim Denning with the 2020 Distinguished Alumnus Award. Dr. Denning earned his doctorate in microbiology and immunology in 2002. Dr. Denning is in the midst of a distinguished career in academic research as the Associate Director of the Institute of Biomedical Sciences at Georgia State University, with more than 50 peer-reviewed publications, many in high-profile journals in his field. He played a key role in launching advanced degree programs in biomedical science and in establishing high biocontainment research at Georgia State. Dr. Denning is recognized nationally and internationally for his work in mucosal immunity. For his many contributions to the scientific community as a researcher and educator, the GSBS is pleased to honor Dr. Tim Denning with the 2020 Distinguished Alumnus Award. We will now hear a short address from Dr. Denning.
Warmest congratulations to the graduates. You all did it. Sorry, y'all did it. I would also like to extend sincere congratulations to the mentors, family and friends, and other dedicated supporters who have encouraged all of you to overcome countless obstacles to reach this moment. I regret that we cannot have a commencement ceremony in person this year for obvious reasons. I actually missed my own commencement ceremony about 17 years ago, as I had defended my dissertation months earlier, and with a full head of hair and a whole lot of excitement, I headed off for a postdoc in sunny La Jolla, California. But I think it is very important to pause at a moment like this, even without a face-to-face commencement, and reflect back over the past several years of your journey. I hope you fully savor your accomplishments, your breakthrough experiments, your posters, your oral presentations, your first author manuscripts, the technical prowess you have amassed. These accomplishments are significant and will set the stage for your future successes. Also remember the struggles during your PhD. Those were not in vain. Don't forget all of those failed experiments, many of you which you have long since forgotten, and others that you have intentionally blocked from your mind for your own mental health. These failures, as you may have considered them, believe it or not, were just as critical as the successful ones in getting you to this point. And they taught you an important lesson that you should carry forward. You are an adept problem solver. So when you encounter the unexpected, draw on this important skill and just think, I got this. Even if you are not so sure you do, you will figure it out along the way. Now, as you look forward, I have a few words of advice. First, please remember that whatever step you take, it is not about the money or the title. It is about the experience. A rich experience will provide value for a lifetime. Second, whether it is salary or space or other tangible things as you migrate through your career, figure out what you absolutely need to be successful and fight for it. Don't get distracted by what you want or by what you think you deserve. Third, always surround yourself with mentors. Ferret them out, keep them close, and soak up their wisdom like a sponge. Inevitably, what they will teach you, actually what they will remind you of, is how to deal with unique and unimaginable challenges in creative, productive ways. And a few last words of advice, as I so fondly remember my days in Galveston and at UTMB in the GSBS. Before you head out, make sure you take one last walk along the seawall. One last stroll along the strand. Eat one last po' boy at Shrimp and Stuff. Some tres leches at Rudy and Paco. And who could forget the best deal in town, a breakfast burrito at La Estacion. Gosh, I'm making myself famished here just reminiscing about these places. And as you cross the causeway, for those of you leaving Galveston, know that the world is truly your oyster. The GSBS UTMB has ideally prepared you for whatever your next step is. I think you will find that the rich experiences you have enjoyed during your graduate education at UTMB will place you on the ideal trajectory towards many rewarding ventures. Know that each one of you is capable of truly transforming this world. Yeah, you heard me right. Truly transforming this world. And just in case there are any doubters out there, which is typical amongst PhDs, I would like to leave you with an African proverb. If you think you are too small to make a difference, you haven't spent a night with a mosquito. This proverb, I must say, reminds me of those Texas-sized mosquitoes that used to follow me into the elevator at the MRB. And that, I can assure you, made a huge difference on the ride upstairs. Graduates, I hope you are as proud of yourselves as all of us are of you. You should cherish this wonderful accomplishment always. Congratulations, doctors.
Thank you, Dr. Denning. I'd like to now ask Dr. Vicente Santa Cruz, president of the GSBS Associates, to address our graduates on behalf of the Alumni Association. Dr. Santa Cruz?
Hello, UTMB GSBS Class of 2020. My name is Vicente Santa Cruz, Experimental Pathology, Class of 2001. On behalf of the UTMB GSBS Associates, I would like to send our warmest congratulations to each and every one of you. Your perseverance and your dedication have allowed you to reach this very important milestone in your careers. We understand that you have spent countless hours, days, nights, and even holidays working on this accomplishment. We also know that not very many people know what you know. And we also know that this was not easy. Always remember those basic values that were taught to you early on in life. Remember your honesty, remember your respect, your collaboration, your integrity, and remember that passion that you have in everything that you do. What's most exciting about today is knowing that you become one of us. You become a fellow alumni. We know that when you come back and visit UTMB's beautiful campus, you will be excited and you will be filled with pride. We also hope that when you come back, or as you accomplish many other success stories, you remember everybody who had an impact on your education and your career. Remember all those faculty and staff that played such an important part. Now, as an alumnus, you will also have many emails and many communications from students wondering how it is that you accomplished what you did. Embrace it and share it. On behalf of the UTMB Associates, we hope that you can become a part of us. We hope that you follow us in our journey to foster all these wonderful things and actions for our fellow students, past students, our staff, and also our faculty. On behalf of the UTMB Associates, I'd like to once again congratulate you and everybody who has supported you through this journey. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Santa Cruz. It's now time to recognize the 2020 class of the Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences. Dr. Joan Nichols, Associate Dean for Student Affairs, Dr. Kristen Peake, Associate Dean for Academic Affairs, and Dr. Daniel Jupiter, Assistant Dean for Recruitment, will read the name of the degree candidates. Dr. Raymer, these students have completed satisfactorily the prescribed curriculum, been certified by the graduate faculty, and are presented to you for the conferring of the degree Master of Science.
By the authority vested in me by the State of Texas and by the Board of Regents of the University of Texas System, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Master of Science, with all rights, honors, and privileges pertaining thereto.
I am Dr. Joan Nichols, Victoria Brem. Victoria's mentor was Catherine Cunningham. Substance abuse disorders, including cocaine and opioid use disorders, are diseases characterized by binge intoxication withdrawal and relapse stages. Ghrelin is an endogenous hormone which exerts its effects via the GHS1 alpha receptor. Both the ligand and the receptor have emerged as potential targets for the treatment of multiple substance abuse disorders. Victoria demonstrated that pharmacologic blockade of the ghrelin receptor suppresses oxycodone intake in both cocaine and oxycodone Q-evoked drug seeking, indicating that this receptor may prove to be a novel target for new pharmaceutical development to decrease the impact of drug intake and relapse vulnerability in cocaine and opioid use disorder. Congratulations, Dr. Brem. Veronica Campbell. Veronica's mentor was Dr. Noel Anastasio. Endophenotypes are biological markers that contain a useful link between genetic sequences and behavioral disorders. Veronica's project looked at motor impulsivity, which is a behavioral endophenotype that contributes to relapse-related behaviors in cocaine and opioid use disorders. Veronica is currently working at St. Charles Hospital, Bend, Oregon, as a laboratory support services assistant. Congratulations, Veronica. Cibrian Hendricks. Cibrian's mentor was Dr. Donald Boyer. Cibrian's project goal was to monitor a park with high recreational activity for the presence of ticks bearing viral and bacterial pathogens. Cibrian and her lab group collected ticks at Huntsville State Park in the summers of 2017 and 2018. They then extracted the DNA and RNA from the collected ticks and examined the ticks for pathogens harmful to humans, such as Lyme disease. After graduation, Cibrian will be changing her education program to one that focuses on genetics. Congratulations, Cibrian. Narmada Labu. Narmada's mentor was Dr. Ram Kumar Menon. Multiple pathways initiate labor in pregnant women. The cellular signaling pathways and molecular mechanisms underlying preterm labor remain unknown. Narmada's project was designed to add to our understanding of molecular signaling that leads to both term and preterm labor. She studied the signaling pathways in fetal membranes as opposed to maternal tissues in order to obtain novel insights into cellular mechanisms of labor. Congratulations, Narmada. Stephen Williams. Stephen's mentor was Dr. Jacques Bergeron. Stephen's project compared costs of radical cystectomy versus trimodal therapy for patients diagnosed with localized muscle invasive bladder cancer. Congratulations, Stephen.
Dr. Raymer, these next students have completed satisfactorily the prescribed curriculum, been certified by the graduate faculty, and are presented to you for the conferring of the degree Master of Medical Science.
By the authority vested in me by the State of Texas and the Board of Regents of the University of Texas System, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Master of Medical Science with all the rights, honors, and privileges pertaining thereto.
Elizabeth Bleers. Elizabeth's mentor was Dr. Craig Porter. Critical limb ischemia, the most severe form of peripheral artery disease, leads to extensive damage and alterations to skeletal muscle function. Elizabeth's project investigated the tissue-specific responses to ischemia, the role of muscle cell, and cellular mitochondrial function in patients with critical limb ischemia. Congratulations, Elizabeth.
Dr. Raymer, these next students have completed satisfactorily the prescribed curriculum, been certified by the graduate faculty, and are presented to you for the conferring of the degree Master of Public Health.
By the authority vested in me by the State of Texas and the Board of Regents of the University of Texas System, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Master of Public Health with all the rights and honors and privileges pertaining thereto.
I'm Dr. Daniel Jupiter. Sonia Lucy Bazanov. Sonia's mentor was Dr. Sapna Kaul. Sonia's research focused on disparities in the use of mental health services among older Hispanic and Black Americans. This includes barriers in access to care, and future studies should look at policy changes to address these disparities. Sonia is currently working in the Winston Lab at UTMB. Congratulations, Dr. Bazanov. Dakota Bramble. Dakota's mentor was Dr. Kara Pennell. Dakota collaborated with the Texas Children's Hospital Section of Public Health and Child Abuse Pediatrics to explore adverse childhood experiences, specifically child sexual abuse, in greater depth. Her work created recommendations and prevention programs to better identify and reduce the number of patients impacted by child sexual abuse. Congratulations, Dakota. Serena Gutierrez. Serena's mentor was Dr. Rebecca Wong. Serena used data from the 2012 and 2015 waves of the Mexican Health and Aging Study to study the association between baseline time usage and depressive symptomatology in 2015. Serena will be starting a doctoral program at UTMB in the fall. Congratulations, Serena. Gafona Idue. Gafona's mentor was Dr. John Prochaska. Gafona used census tract data collected from Census FactFinder for the purpose of looking at the geographic distribution of social determinants of health across the United States. Variables studied included education, Gini index, race, gender, and income. Congratulations, Gafona. Amy Krakus. Amy's mentor was Dr. Kara Pennell. Amy addressed the fact that medical students in the U.S. have little to no exposure to aerospace medicine. She created a 6-lecture mini-curriculum in aerospace medicine and piloted it with UTMB medical students. There was a significant increase in awareness of aerospace medicine career opportunities and knowledge of aerospace medicine on post-curriculum testing. Amy is completing her residency in aerospace medicine. Congratulations, Amy. Yanis Malagaris. Yanis's mentor was Dr. Christopher Jennings. Acute otitis media is one of the most common childhood infections, and several mechanisms have been proposed relating seasonality of birth with risk of disease. Yanis found that the time of birth has a significant nonlinear relationship with nasopharyngeal microbial load in infants.
Giannis is currently a postdoctoral fellow at UTMB. Congratulations, Giannis. Cherith Naig. Cherith's mentor was Dr. Henny Sirag. Cherith carried out a qualitative study looking at the health risks and barriers to health care that are experienced by child migrants from Central America and Mexico, which in part is affected by socioeconomic policies, health systems, and social norms in both their countries of origin and destination. Congratulations, Cherith. Evstatia Polychronopoulou. Evstatia's mentor was Dr. Yongfeng Kuo. EFI study compared the performance of three data mining methods in their ability to detect signals of adverse events associated with trastuzumab in elderly breast cancer patients. EFI is currently working at UTMB in the Office of Biostatistics and pursuing a PhD. Congratulations, EFI. Robert Rodriguez. Robert's mentor was Dr. Kara Pennell. Pre-exposure prophylaxis, or PrEP, has been scientifically proven to reduce HIV transmission up to 90% per the FDA. Robert studied the efficacy of the PrEP program of Galveston County as a model designed to provide access to and providable health care and affordable health care for HIV vulnerable populations. Robert is currently pursuing a PhD in population health sciences at UTMB. Congratulations, Robert. Megan Steele. I was Megan's mentor. Megan carried out an analysis of the county-level variations in opioid-related deaths and emergency department admissions across Texas. Her work concluded with a call for more resources and better quality surveillance for rural counties. Megan will be working for the Kentucky Injury Prevention and Research Center. Congratulations, Megan. Jay Truitt. I was Jay's mentor. Jay's work explored the efficacy and utility of remote dermoscopy in treating and diagnosing melanoma. Jay is completing his residency in dermatology at Texas Tech. Congratulations, Jay. Ann Tsung. I was Ann's mentor. Ann's project examined the utility of osteogenic exercise in improving bone health and strength. A future goal is to perform studies on healthy and astronaut populations. Ann is completing her residency in aerospace medicine. Congratulations, Ann. Jenny Wang. Jenny's mentor was Dr. Kara Pennell. Jenny's research explored the role of medical conditions and medications that may lead to high gravity intolerance. Her work used the aerobatic pilot population involved in fatal accidents. Congratulations, Jenny.
Dr. Raymer, these next students have completed satisfactorily the prescribed curriculum, been certified by the graduate faculty, and are presented to you for the conferring of the degree Doctor of Philosophy.
By the authority vested in me by the State of Texas and the Board of Regents of the University of Texas System, I hereby confer upon you the degree Doctor of Philosophy with all the rights, honors, and privileges pertaining thereto.
Susan L. Arby. Susan's mentor was Dr. Parinley Ankabhattar. Full-thickness, large burn wounds are temporarily covered with cadaver skin because of the limited availability of the patient's own autologous skin as a treatment. To overcome this obstacle, Susan developed methods to produce autologous keratinocyte sheets as a substitute for autologous skin grafts. Her project defined methods of production of keratinocyte sheets as a treatment for severe burns. Congratulations, Dr. L. Arby.
Ashley Smith. Ashley's mentor was Dr. Jonathan Hommel. Ashley's project involved development of a better understanding of the interconnected mechanisms of signaling that may underlie pathological overconsumption of high-fat food and identified the neuropeptide receptor NMUR2 and the neurotransmitter glutamate as novel regulators of binge-type eating, intake of high-fat food, and motivation for high-fat food. Congratulations, Dr. Smith.
Gabriella Uribe. Gabriella's mentor was Dr. Irina Pinchuk. In response to infection, the host activates innate immune receptors using the signaling molecule MYD88, which induces protective inflammatory and antimicrobial responses. Gabriella's doctoral project was looking at the role of mesenchymal MYD88 signaling under the homeostasis and initiation of inflammation in colon cancer. Congratulations, Dr. Uribe.
Maria Alcorn. Maria's mentor was Dr. David Beasley. Maria studied attenuating and revertant mutations, which result in changes in the receptor binding domain in the envelope protein of West Nile virus. She assessed the impact that mutations had on phenotypes that are associated with attenuation of neurotropic flaviviruses and whether the revertant mutations partially or fully restored any altered phenotypes. Congratulations, Dr. Elkhorn. Stephen Halam. Stephen's mentor was Dr. Slobodan Pestler. Hunin virus is a virus that causes Argentine hemorrhagic fever. Candid 1 is a vaccine for Argentine hemorrhagic fever. By understanding the genetic determinants related to virulence in the vaccine strain of Candid 1, Stephen hoped to advance vaccine development for related arenaviruses. Stephen also characterized a novel attenuation strategy in Hunin virus based on the viral Z protein. And this protein normally plays an important role in virion assembly and release from infected cells. Congratulations, Dr. Halam. Elizabeth Matier. Elizabeth's mentor was, again, Dr. Slobodan Pestler. An important step in the initiation of innate immune response to virus infection is the recognition of viral RNAs, including double-stranded RNA. Viral double-stranded RNA is readily detectable during New World, but not Old World arenavirus infection. Elizabeth found that the Old World loss of virus, nuclear protein, and L proteins are required for the suppression of New World Hunin virus-induced double-stranded RNA and subsequent induction of the host innate immune response. Elizabeth is currently working at MedPACE, a clinical contract research organization based in Cincinnati, Ohio. Congratulations, Dr. Matier. Adam Ronk. Adam's mentor was Dr. Alexander Bukhrayev. Adam's work focused on developing our understanding of the interactions between Ebola virus and its bat reservoir by comparing aspects of the behavior and evolution of the virus in bats to the same mechanisms and processes as they occur in humans. Alex is currently continuing to work with Dr. Bukhrayev's lab on development of Department of Defense-funded projects. Congratulations, Dr. Ronk. Brendan Trent. Brendan's mentor was Dr. Lin Sung. One of the most life-threatening conditions that can arise in scrub typhus patients is acute respiratory distress syndrome. Brendan examined the lung microenvironment and cellular interactions with the organism that may help elucidate disease pathogenesis and possible development of treatments for scrub typhus. Congratulations, Dr. Trent. Sasha Azar. The title of Sasha's project was Blood Meal Determinants of Zika Virus Infection of Aedes aegypti Mosquitoes. Sasha's mentor was Dr. Scott Weaver. Mosquitoes are more easily infected with arthropod-borne viruses when the mosquito takes a blood meal from a live animal compared to a lab-generated facsimile. Sasha's dissertation work examined what mammalian blood factors play a role in this finding using Zika virus and Aedes aegypti mosquitoes as a model system. After graduation, Sasha will be working as a postdoctoral fellow under the co-mentorship of Dr. Nico Spasilakis and Dr. Shannon Rossi. Congratulations, Dr. Azar. Andrea Dimmitt. Andrea's mentor was Dr. Kelly Dinnelly. The purpose of Andrea's work was to explore the use of peroxisome proliferator activated receptor gamma agonists to treat neurological disorders. Though the agonists have shown some benefit as treatment options, the mechanisms are not entirely understood, particularly for cocaine use disorder. Congratulations, Andrea. Christopher Michael Roundy. Christopher's mentor was Dr. Scott Weaver. Christopher studied changes that occurred to Aedes aegypti as they adapted to laboratory conditions after being collected from the field. An increase in how well they transmit Zika was associated with changes to their microbiome and other factors. Understanding how mosquitoes we study in the lab are different than those in the field allows us to improve our virus transmission models. Christopher will be taking a postdoctoral research position with Dr. Gabe Hammer at Texas A&M University, and he will be studying medical entomology. Congratulations, Dr. Roundy. Harris Weiss. Harris's mentor was Dr. Helen Helmick. Harris found that there was evidence of long-lasting dysregulation of gene expression, especially in immunological gene expression following traumatic brain injury. He also showed that there were evidence that chronic activation of both deleterious and beneficial genes remained for up to 1 year post-injury. His work suggests that a regenerative response might be augmented by therapeutic intervention long after the initial traumatic brain injury occurred. Congratulations, Dr. Weiss. Eldris Elmer. Eldris' mentors were Dr. Haito Hu and Dr. Lin Sung. Myeloid lineage cells such as macrophages are important human immunodeficiency virus reservoirs in the central nervous system. Elder showed that a BRD4 selective small molecule induced potent and durable suppression of HIV in human myeloid cells, with potential utility in combination with antiretroviral therapy to better control HIV-associated neurological disorders. After graduation, Dr. Elmer will be a member. He is an assistant professor at Jizan University, Saudi Arabia. Congratulations, Dr. Elmer. Jacqueline Kaiser. Jacqueline's mentor was Dr. Alan Barrett. West Nile virus causes neurological disease and fatalities annually, but there is no licensed vaccine for people. The goal of Jacqueline's project was to investigate mutations in West Nile virus that could weaken the virus and be useful in development of a live attenuated vaccine. Congratulations, Dr. Kaiser. Brittany Ross. Brittany's mentor was Dr. Alfredo Torres. The bacterium Bucalderia pseudomallei causes a chronic infection that has a mortality rate up to 40% regardless of treatment. To survive harsh environments, the bacteria enters a dormant state. Brittany focused on identifying genes involved in the initiation of dormancy following antibiotic exposure and infection of human cells. Brittany is currently working in Maven Whitley's lab at Georgia Institute of Technology. Congratulations, Dr. Ross. Teresa Servillo. Teresa's mentor was Dr. Timus Geisbert. While extensive research has been conducted in order to advance Lassa virus vaccine and therapeutic development, less research attention has been focused on the development of countermeasures against Hunin virus. The focus of Teresa's dissertation was to address the limitations of currently available Hunin virus countermeasures through the development of novel strategies for virus detection and prevention. Congratulations, Teresa. Grace Thaxton. Grace's mentor was Dr. Peter Melby. Acute malnutrition or wasting is driven by an intense period of energy or nutrient deprivation, leading to dangerously reduced weight. Grace identified plasma biomarkers that are representative of intestinal health, liver function, and metabolism in children with moderate acute malnutrition. These biomarkers should be measured over the course of recovery from moderate acute malnutrition to determine if they are accountable proxies for recovery of specific systems that are impaired during development of moderate acute malnutrition. Congratulations, Grace. Jessica DeRay. Jessica's mentor was Dr. Fernanda Leiza. The progress of developing effective interventions against psychiatric disorders has been limited due to the lack of understanding of the underlying cellular and functional mechanisms. Recent research findings focused on exploring novel causes of psychiatric disorders have highlighted the importance of the axonal initial segment, a highly specialized neuronal structure critical for spike initiation of the action potential. FGF14 is a non-secreted neuronal protein and an integral component of the axonal initial segment. Jessica's project looked at contributions of FGF14 to the pathophysiology of psychiatric disorders. Congratulations, Dr. DeRay. Karen Adams. Karen's mentor was Dr. Carolyn Phillips. Karen's project was to study the Employee Assistance Program and occupational health providers' perceptions and experiences with intimate partner violence. Congratulations, Dr. Adams. Stephanie Bailey. Stephanie's mentor was Dr. Carolyn Phillips. Stephanie's project was to study nursing relationships in the neonatal intensive care unit. Congratulations, Dr. Bailey. Kelsey Ray Kent. Kelsey's mentor was Dr. Mary O'Keefe. Kelsey's project examined relationships between gastrointestinal disease and post-traumatic stress disorder in United States military veterans. Kelsey used data provided by the Department of Veterans Affairs to show that PTSD patients did not correlate with ulcerative colitis, but did correlate with GI diseases of gastroesophageal reflux disease, peptic ulcer disease, functional dyspepsia, Crohn's disease, diverticular disease, and irritable bowel syndrome. Congratulations, Dr. Kent. Chatoy King. Chatoy's mentor was Dr. Linda Rounds. Nigerian immigrant nursing students have difficulty understanding vocabulary and terminology used in U.S. nursing programs curriculum. There's limited research associated with Nigerians and how they acclimate to U.S. nursing programs. The goal for this project was to look at U.S. nursing schools and incorporate positive strategies to assist Nigerian immigrant nursing students. After graduation, Dr. King will continue in her career in nursing education at University of Houston, Clear Lake, in the RNBSN nursing program. Congratulations, Dr. King. Madeline Lynette Rogers. Madeline's mentor was Dr. Mary O'Keefe. Madeline's doctoral project evaluated the awareness of cardiovascular risk in adults with type 2 diabetes, as well as the reliability of a new instrument for cardiovascular risk awareness. Most of the participants were aware of their risk, however, they had low perception of developing the disease. Reliability of the new instrument was demonstrated. Congratulations, Dr. Rogers. Catherine Strout. Catherine's mentor was Dr. Therese Verklan. Catherine's doctoral project showed that adults with diabetes mellitus experiencing homelessness are at risk of development of preventable diabetic foot ulcers and or amputation, and that adults provided with foot care education were able to change diabetic foot self-care behaviors. After graduation, Dr. Strout will be at the University of Texas at Tyler School of Nursing. Congratulations, Dr. Strout. Michelle Wilson. Michelle's mentor was Dr. Bruce Leonard. There are large numbers of homeless children enrolled in the United States schools who face significant health and learning challenges. While school nurses are in the prime position to intervene, little is known about their experience and perceptions of working with homeless elementary school-aged children. Michelle's study was designed to explore the experience and perceptions of school nurses working with homeless elementary school-aged children. Congratulations, Dr. Wilson. Michelle Ann Land. Michelle's mentor was Dr. Nicole Anastasio. Vulnerability to developing cocaine use disorder starts with a background of genetics and environment and results in changes in the brain that lead to a greater drive to take cocaine. Michelle identified genetic and epigenetic markers of a system called the 5-HT2R system, with great potential to define a high-risk relapse biosignature of cocaine use disorder that will help to move treatments toward an age of precision medicine. After graduation, Michelle will be working as a postdoctoral fellow at Baylor College of Medicine in the Neuroscience Department under Dr. Francois St. Pierre. Congratulations, Dr. Land. Dennis Scholler. The National Institute on Drug Abuse highlighted the need for pharmacological targets to treat substance use disorders. Dennis provided preclinical evidence that the 5-HT2AR antagonist inverse agonist, PIM-abacarin, perhaps through actions in the medial prefrontal cortex, may promote abstinence in substance abuse disorders. Dennis is in a postdoctoral fellowship program currently in Behavioral Pharmacology Research Institute, Johns Hopkins University School of Medicine. Congratulations, Dr. Scholler.
I'm Dr. Kristen Peake. Zulkarnain Javed. Zul's mentor was Dr. Jacques Balargian. Zul's study was the first nationally representative study of middle-aged and older men to examine testosterone replacement therapy prescribing patterns by depression status and the association between hypogonadism, testosterone replacement therapy, and depression. His findings will improve existing knowledge of the subject and inform future research in light of methodological challenges. Dr. Javed is currently a postdoctoral fellow at the Morehouse School of Medicine. Congratulations, Dr. Javed. Christopher Messenger. I was Christopher's mentor. Chris's dissertation examined how poorly understood working conditions limits the ability to evaluate factors threatening workers' health. Concomitantly, there exists an underutilization of information on the role of work stress in perpetuating health disparities. His findings showed evidence of an association between psychosocial work stress and health, but no evidence suggesting a role in health disparities. After graduation, Chris will remain a faculty member here at UTMB in the School of Health Professions in the Department of Nutrition and Metabolism. Congratulations, Dr. Messenger. Rehabilitation Sciences. Juliana Dean. Juliana's mentor was Dr. Timothy Reistetter. Juliana's dissertation looked at health equity as a goal of the American healthcare system. However, social risk factors impact health outcomes regardless of high standards of care. Social capital or resources available from the community structure is a risk factor in the community context that can significantly affect whether an individual is successfully discharged to the community after post-acute care. After graduation, Juliana will continue her tenure track assistant professor position at the University of Houston, Clear Lake. Congratulations, Dr. Dean. Giannis Malagaris. Giannis's mentor is Dr. Ken Ottenbacher. Giannis's dissertation focused on how burn survivors experience severe muscle mass wasting. Using retrospective analysis of body composition scans and stable isotope metabolic studies data, he found that burn pediatric patients lose lean mass in the extremities while accumulating fat in the trunk, and that the muscle protein breakdown rate is higher in male relative to female patients. After graduation, Giannis will continue as a postdoctoral fellow in the Seeley Center on Aging. Congratulations, Dr. Malagaris. Jaspreet Sodhi. Jaspreet's mentor was Dr. Soham Alsney. Jaspreet's dissertation showed that pain is a strong independent predictor of functional limitations, disability, and frailty. The findings suggest that early intervention and better management of pain is needed to prevent disability and frailty, enhance patient management, help adults maintain independence, and lower the burden of pain among older adult Americans. After graduation, Jaspreet will continue working as a postdoctoral fellow associate at St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. Congratulations, Dr. Sodhi.
The following candidates have worked concurrently on both the Doctor of Philosophy and the Doctor of Medicine degrees in our combined MD-PhD program. According to the rules of that program, the official date of the award of Doctor of Philosophy degree concurs with the date that the Doctor of Medicine degree is awarded. The School of Medicine graduation ceremony will be held virtually in 2 weeks on Saturday, May 30th, 2020. Dr. Raymer, these next students have completed satisfactorily the prescribed curriculum, been certified by the graduate faculty, and are presented to you for the conferring of the degree Doctor of Philosophy.
By the authority vested in me by the State of Texas and the Board of Regents of the University of Texas System, I hereby confer upon you the degree Doctor of Philosophy with all the rights, honors, and privileges pertaining thereto.
Yeki Song. Yeki's mentor is Dr. Jeff Ferroni. Yeki's dissertation was an ethnography on how medical students use Reddit, an anonymous news aggregating forum, to discuss the concept of burnout. The study of this online space revealed that the social, economic, and political forces present within the larger structure of medical education profoundly affected the ability of individuals to find existential fulfillment and resist dehumanization. After graduation, Yeki will be starting her residency in psychiatry at Duke University. Congratulations, Dr. Song. Brian Dawes. Brian's mentor was Dr. Alexander Freiberg. Using a human neuron astrocyte co-cultures, Brian studied the effects of emerging encephalitic viruses on human neural cells. He showed that lacrosse virus induces strong pro-inflammatory responses, which may contribute to pathology, and that NIFA virus inhibits pro-inflammatory response. He also showed that a type 1 interferon, but not type 2 interferon, inhibit NIFA virus replication in human neural cells. After graduation, he will be beginning his residency at Stanford University in internal medicine. Congratulations, Dr. Dawes. Amanda Elizabeth Price. Amanda's mentor was Dr. Catherine Cunningham. Addictive disorders such as substance use disorder and binge eating disorder are characterized by underlying behaviors that are driven by changes to brain chemistry and circuitry. The goal of Amanda's project was to explore four new strategies as therapeutic opportunities in the treatment of addictive disorders with a special emphasis on binge eating disorder. After graduation, Amanda will be starting a residency program in general psychiatry at the University of North Carolina Hospital in Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Congratulations, Dr. Price.
So at this time, I would like to ask Dr. Tracy Tolliver-Kinsky, Director of the Basic Biomedical Science Curriculum, to recite the Biomedical Scientist's Oath for our new graduates. Graduates are invited to repeat these words. Dr. Tolliver.
In accepting my doctoral or master's degree, I accept the following responsibilities. I will use my scientific expertise and skills to the benefit of all people. I have an obligation to honor the trust others have in my work and to treat the work of other researchers with respect. I understand the scientific enterprise is built on a foundation of trust, and I will gather data, analyze data, and present ideas ethically and carefully. I will convey scientific principles in mentoring and in public debate. I understand that I have an obligation to act in ways that serve the public, and I will seek to increase their understanding of science and publicly defend science and its principles. These things I promise.
Thank you, Dr. Tolliver. I'd also like to thank the GSBS faculty and the GSBS staff for their support of this year's graduating class. I would like to ask families and friends to help celebrate the accomplishments of our students. Many of you deserve special thanks for your emotional and financial support. It has been a pleasure observing these graduates progress as students. Each of them will be a credit to themselves, to UTMB, and to you. Please accept my sincere and heartfelt congratulations to each of our graduates today. This is a day of celebration for all of us, and UTMB shares your pride of accomplishment and your hope for a bright future. As you depart UTMB and start the next chapter in your life, I encourage you to always believe in what you do and to always remember why you do it, to improve the health of the people of Texas and around the world. Again, congratulations to each of our graduates and best wishes for continued success throughout your careers. This concludes today's commencement ceremony. Be safe.
Dear students, I want to add my good wishes to each one of you who are graduating this year. May all of you have a bright future and make us all proud of your continued successes and achievements. None of you will ever forget the historic nature of the year in which you are graduating. All of you will have the unique distinction of graduating in the year all humanity hit the pause button due to the global pandemic. It is the year when our planet Earth was able to breathe more easily with cleaner air and cleaner ocean waters, the likes of which your generation may not have seen, but may have heard from your parents and grandparents. I will leave you with a mathematical puzzle, which is also special to 2020, the year of your graduation. If you add your age to the year you were born in, it will equal 2020, irrespective of when and where you were born. Apparently, this amazing phenomenon only happens once in 1,000 years. So you are a special class of graduates who graduated this unique and historical year of 2020. Congratulations.
Congratulate all of the students throughout the graduate school for their perseverance during the past several years that they've been in the laboratory and what they've been able to achieve. I'm sure, as you will hear from everyone, that this has been a most unexpected ending to their graduate life. But I think never before have we needed them as much as we need you now to go into the next stages of your careers. Science has become a much more important endeavor than we probably have ever seen in our lifetimes. I think all the faculty will agree with that. And we must pass the torch to all of you. We are extremely confident that you will move forward and bring science back into the light and show really humanity what we're able to do for it.
To all of the graduates who are finishing up their master's and their PhD degrees and going out into the workforce to make our world a better place and to explore and investigate and make discoveries and to make a difference in our communities and in patients' lives. I want to say a special congratulations to our Master of Public Health students who are graduating. I wish we could all be together in person to celebrate this, but hopefully we'll have a chance to do that at some point in the future. Congratulations again.
Dear students, congratulations to all of you for your dedication, perseverance during all those years, and I wish you the best for your entire future.
Congratulations to each and every one of you. Because we can't be there with you today does not mean that we are not any less proud of every one of you and all that you have accomplished. And no more importantly than now, I think you will all be able to realize how important what you've learned and what you will be doing for society, for our communities, and for science moving forward has been more transparent and obvious to you. So we wish you all the best of luck. We couldn't be prouder of you. Thank you for all the hard work that you've put in over the past several years. It will pay off.
Congratulations to all master and PhD graduate students for your major accomplishments during the training at UTMB. And I also want to specially mention Edros Elmer, who is a Michael student, graduated also, and he works on HIV drug development. And also he will have a faculty position as assistant professor in immunology and microbiology in his home country in Saudi Arabia. Wherever you go and whatever positions you will be, we are all sure that you will do very well and we're proud of you for all your achievement. Congratulations again.
So congratulations to all the graduates, and specifically the graduates in the HBTM program. I think that this time of COVID-19, the skills and abilities that you learned as part of your translational directed curriculum hopefully will serve you well in the future. And I'm confident that you'll be able to make contributions to advancing improvement in human health. I really also want to say thank you. Thank you for, you know, giving me the opportunity to participate in your education and the fulfillment that I get from seeing you advance in your careers.
Welcome, UTMB graduates, and congratulations to you all. Special thanks to the Pharmacology and Toxicology program graduates, and for your family and friends who have been companion in your journey here at UTMB. It feels like yesterday when we were preparing your admission letter and helping you finding the right mentors. And journey to graduation takes both parts. It takes mentors and students. You have learned from us, and we have learned from you. We have learned from your personal stories, from your hurdles, from your excitement and passion for research and science. We are very grateful that you have chosen us to be part of this important step of your life. You have developed new skills, you have developed new competency, but most importantly, you have grown into a unique scientist who's ready to take on the world and make an impact in the society. And at that point, we will be here for you. We will be here for you all lifelong and supporting you in your endeavors. And we are proud of you, and congratulations.
Congratulations to all the graduate students, the PhD and the MD PhD students. I wish you all the luck and look forward to in the future reading of your accomplishments, your prizes you're going to win, the discoveries that you're going to make, and the impact that you're going to have on science. And I'm sure you're going to do all proud to UTMB.
Hi, graduates. I want to congratulate you on successfully completing your degree. This is a major accomplishment and milestone in your life that required determination, hard work, and love for scientific investigation. The current pandemic illustrates the importance of science and the role scientists play in improving the health and well-being of society. I know your training at UTMB has prepared you well and will allow you to explore many exciting career opportunities that lie ahead. Through your training, it's inevitable that you will have a positive impact on science and the career path that you choose. Continue to make contributions in science in all the ways that you are able. We are proud of you, and the best is yet to come.
So basically, as part of what I do, being Dean of Student Affairs, is I review all of the theses and dissertations that are submitted every year. And I have to say that I have been hugely impressed by the quality of the documents that students have prepared this term. Despite the hardships and difficulties they have faced, finishing their programs, finishing their research, putting this all together, doing their dissertations online, the documents that have been prepared this year are the best I've ever seen. And I wouldn't recommend we go through this every time, but I just wanted to just tell these students what an amazing job they've done and congratulate all of you.
Hi, graduates. I just want to say from the graduate school that we are so very proud of you and your accomplishments, especially during this crazy pandemic time. You make us very, very proud. From the public health side, I want to say a special shout out to all of our trainees who are graduating and going into a very uncertain world. We need your expertise now more than ever.
Congratulations for the great work that you've done, for the great work that you're going to do. School isn't made up of the books. It isn't made up of the lab. It's made up of the people. And you're a really big part of that. So we thank you for the time that you spent here and for making us what we are.
Congratulations, graduates. It's been an honor being your peer, and you guys have definitely inspired me to make my own science better. And I hope that I will be joining you in the next month or so. So congratulations. The effort is extreme, but well worth it in the end, and you guys have made it. Congrats.
All of you on achieving a major milestone in your education and your careers. And a special congratulations, since I can't be there to hood you, to Shatoy King. Congratulations, you did some wonderful research. It was a pleasure.
Congratulations, graduates, on a successful outcome of your hard work and perseverance, and best wishes for a successful and fulfilling future.
On your graduation, and best wishes on your next journey. Rose Garcia, Recruitment Coordinator. Thank you all for all your help during the recruitment process.
No matter where you are, no matter what you do, never stop believing in yourself. Congratulations on your graduation.
To all of this year's graduates, I especially want to shout out for the infectious disease students who do amazing work here at UTMB that raises the level of everyone's science and who are going to be needed more than ever with this COVID pandemic and probably many more infectious diseases to come. So congratulations, and we look forward to your future careers of many contributions. Just wanted to give a personal congratulations to my two students, Chris Roundy and Sasha Azar. I think they set two new records here at UTMB along with some of the other students. They graduated in the same year from the same lab, which I think is at least a first for me. And I think they're the first students to go through two pandemics, starting with Zika, right after they joined the program, and ending with COVID. And let's hope that thanks to your future contributions, these will be the last pandemics to come around for a long time. Congratulations, Chris and Sasha.
Congratulations on reaching this milestone, and we are all wishing y'all great success with your career. I did have a quote that I thought was very meaningful, especially for our researchers. It's from Ralph Waldo Emerson, and it says, "Do not follow where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and leave a trail." I think that's very meaningful for the students in their career and in their future dreams. So congratulations, y'all.
Hey, congratulations, Idris. Go and get them. Keep in touch from Saudi Arabia. Good luck.